الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. نحمده كما يجب لعظيم وجهه وجلال سلطانه حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما شاء من شيء بعد. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن حبيبه وصفيه وخليله محمد بن عبد الله رسول الله للناس كافة، بعثه الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وسراجا منيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه عدد ما أحاط به علمك، وخط به قلمك، وأحصاه كتابك. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين، واجعلنا من التوابين، واجعلنا من المتطهرين، واجعلنا من ورثة جنة النعيم. آمين آمين آمين. We praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We thank him and we beg of his mercy and we seek his light to see better what is right and do it, and to see what is wrong and avoid it. And we seek his guidance all the time, every time. We bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his servant and messenger. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam and Iman, undoubtedly today there is more knowledge than any time before, including religious knowledge. The abundance of books and internet and information is unprecedented. No one can argue against that. Anything you want it, it's there. Undoubtedly, you can get any information, including fatwas, including, you know, things about religion, things about history. You can even find out about your ancestors. You know, you can do, genetic test for $100 or $200. They tell you where you're coming from, what part your ancestors came from. They will give you all the DNA information you need. What diseases you might be prone to, what, you know, risks you may or may not have. All of these things, unbelievable, unprecedented knowledge. And this is something that cannot be argued. Knowledge is abundant. As a matter of fact, at the tip of your fingers, all of you, through your smartphones, which are now mini computers, you can access knowledge anywhere you are in the world. Having said that, is it knowledge that brings people together, or is it something else? We have a lot of knowledge. I have seen, this is my observation, when there is more knowledge and focus on knowledge and virtue is based only on knowledge, you know, there isn't much love and unity. So this is a field study documented, and you can do it on your own. I visited places where people were very simple. They knew Allah, they knew there is Day's Judgment, they knew Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They fed more, they donated more, they built more, they cared more, they did. This is a fact. I went to India, South Asia. I went to Southeast Asia, Indonesia, Malaysia, Africa, Europe, South America, you name it, and I compare. Where there is so much emphasis on love and relationship and caring for one another, you could see more results. Where there is too much on the books and total dissociation of reality, you hear more of gossip and putting down people and focusing on, you know, trivial things that are unnecessary. And you could see even the image of Islam in that area or that community is, you know, not as good or even close to the one that focuses on spreading khair, spreading love, spreading help. We need to ask ourselves. We need to ask ourselves as we're starting now this new year, Islamic New Year, what made them different? And what made those villages in Pakistan and India and Guyana and Lebanon and, you know, Palestine, what made them much better than us in terms of care and concern? They had little means, we have a lot. We have more ways to communicate, yet we don't stand watching or looking at each other. They had less means, but they had love. And when they met, they expressed it in the best ways. So what are we losing? Is it knowledge the way? Knowledge is good. But if it is not ilmun nafi', a useful practical knowledge, it can become deadly. Hence, there are many Islamic movements now. But a'udhu billah from many. Their intention is good, but they are destroying each other more than building things. Focusing on each other's faults. Focusing on so-and-so sheikh's mistakes. They are fighting, saying, ana khayrun min, I am better than him. This very same thing shaitan said when Allah ordered him to do sujood to Adam. And he did not look at Adam being a creation of Allah that I should honor. And Allah has privileged Adam like the angels. وَقُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا فَسَجَدُوا فَعْفَى. You know, in Arabic, they didn't argue, they didn't think. سَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ. He was thinking, why? The imam stands up, please brothers, we have a family, has problems, can you donate? Why is the imam asking? We have to collect food for Syria. We have to collect this. What are they doing with this money? We are having too much doubt of each other. We don't trust each other. We pray with each other. But that's why our prayer is not as good as their prayers. When the Rasul ﷺ used to say, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَالِ. Let us come together and pray to Allah. Everyone says something, there is no more trust. What does he mean? We're growing a generation that is doubting everything that is said. When parents out of love want to tell the children, stay away from so and so, they are asking questions. Everybody's asking questions. And shaitan was the first one who asked questions rather than submitted to Allah. Why do I have to make sujood to him? Why? Do we have to understand? Wallahi, my humble experience, I find more love with simple people who may not know much, a lot. And as a matter of fact, who spread Islam anyways? Let me take you, fly over the globe. Who spread Islam in Central Asia? What is now Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Turkestan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, all the way to Uyghur country, to China. Who spread it? Humble fuqara, Sufi, simple people, all they know, Allah. They were just, you know, they were true Sufi, like the Ahlu Taqashuf were Zuhd, and they were people, they spread Islam. Who spread Islam in Africa? Darawish, fuqara from Morocco, what is now Algeria, and they went down. They mixed with people. They didn't speak no Fulani, no Uluf, no Hausa, nothing. All they had is a smile, a universal language of love. And people entered in Islam. Who spread Islam in the largest country, largest Muslim country in the world, Indonesia? It just came from there. 300 million people. More mosques than any other country. More universities and schools and hafids than any country. Subhanallah. How did Islam, they tell you some stories, subhanallah. It was the language of love, not the language of Arabic or this. They loved Arabic. Not because of the language, because of the people who spoke it. We have to ask ourselves, what is that thing that we're doing which is making our work, whether our children or our neighbors or the society at large? So we have to revive the very language of love that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used. What did the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam do? All of you know what he did. First thing, لما قدم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة آخى بين المهاجرين والأنصار. This is the first thing before building the masjid. The first thing he did, he established a love relationship. Ummah was born 1437 years ago out of mu'akhah. You don't know him, he doesn't know you, and we make you brothers. You don't ask him, where are you from? Who your father was? Which tribe? Oh, you're related to me. Oh, you're from my country. Let's get together. Today, you're from my country, I'll talk to you. Then when I know from your country, from a different tribe, I'll fight with you. And that's, you cannot marry my daughter, I cannot marry your, my son cannot marry your daughter. And vice versa. Allahu Akbar. So alhamdulillah, we have a good example. Second thing, what did the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he built the masjid, he stood in front of everybody, including non-Muslims. And I remind you to remind people of his famous inauguration speech. Our Prime Minister just had inauguration speech. Al-Rasul Sassim had inauguration speech, not from the minbar of Khitaba and Nubuwa, but member of Da'wah, of rulership, of government. His famous charter of Medina. Study it, learn it, understand it, apply it. I don't need knowledge that is useless, that is only the putting down people or making people categories, or this is better or that, or judging people by how long is the beard or how long is the hijab. That is not doing anything for Islam. We need a knowledge that brings people closer to Allah. Remember very well this too, if you can remember. What is the mission of every messenger of Allah? It is my mission too, and your mission. Number one, to bring people closer to Allah. Remember that. Summarize Islam. Let us not adopt too much information is no good. Wallahi, it will be against you. We need practical, as the some like to say, ilmu al-hal. Ilmu al-hal wa ilmu al-ma'al. Ilmu al-hal, knowing every situation where I am, what is muradullah fiha? What does Allah want me to do in this? What is His murad? What is His maqsad? And I have to understand, I am in this situation. I am doing Hajj now. What am I supposed to do? I am in a situation of conflict of interest. What am I supposed to do? I have a problem between my own children or between my own siblings or family problem. What does Allah want me to do right now? That is called ilm al-hal. Including how do I pray Jum'ah? How do I make wudu? How do I fast Ramadan? How do I give my zakat? How do I do marriage? How do I do divorce? All of this is something that I have to know as a Muslim. Not in details, but at least in performance and intention niyyah. So, two things. Number one is to bring people closer to Allah. Number two, mission number two, to bring people closer to one another. Thereby you have all the rulings of Islam. You have all the rulings of Islam. Your job in this life, to bring people closer, including yourself, to Allah. Next step, bring people, whether it's da'wah, or reminding people, or, you know, spreading Islam, or lecture, or teaching, or by your manners, bring people closer to Allah. So, إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, من أحب العباد إلى الله, who are the most loved people to Allah, people ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. خيار الناس, the best people. قال الذين إذا رؤوا, those who are when they are seen, ذكروا الناس بالله, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Those when seen, they remind people of Allah. Am I and you, are you with that? Are we Muslims when seen in the world? I just came from the largest interfaith conference, the World Parliament of Religion. Everybody was talking about some religion, specific religion, and I will tell you which one. They were so amazed. Christians, Jews, Hindus, Buddhists, you name every religion. 10,500 people. We just came a couple of weeks ago. Everybody loved the Sikh community. Everybody spoke in the elevators. They say, wow, amazing people. They remind you of God. Why? They had a booth. We had some Muslim booths. All they want to give is a Quran. I said, brothers, you give Quran, give some sweets. Give some baklava. Give some gulab jamun. Give something sweet. Some chocolate. Quran. This, the chocolate or the sweet has more impact than the Quran. They have a booth. They say, would you like to try our turban? To see how we... And people love it. Yeah, put the turban. And when they put it, wow, can I take a picture for you? Here is a picture. Would you like to, during this 4 days conference, to wear it? Yes. I don't have to do my hair. And they give them itr, some nice perfume. And for 4 days, they had langar. Langar to feed 10,500 people. Vegetarian food, dal, rice, palpaneer, and some fruits, and lassi, mango lassi, and they feed. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. Like the Quran says. So you go, please take off your shoes, please cover your head, man, please this, women. I said, what is this, subhanAllah, Islam? Where are the Muslims? They came, they walked, and all dressed up in white. Nice. Turban white, they look. Man with beard, women with hijab and everything. You eat, they serve you, please have more, please have more. And then they come, please, can you tell others that all what you see here, food what's left, is going to go to the shelter. And all these new carpets and all this furniture is going to go to help people with the homeless people. Thank you. And every 15, 20 minutes they come and tell you food. And then thank you. They say, no, don't say thank you. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to serve you. No attitude, with love and smile. Everybody, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created the heavens and the earth. They said, this is the people of Allah. Go give lectures. Go read the whole Zabur and Quran and Injil and Taurat. It will not do. It is muamala. So, bringing people closer to Allah and bringing people closer to one another. إصلاح. لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من من أمر بمعروف أو صدقة أو إصلاح بين الناس. There is no good in their gatherings. They get together, people sit in the coffee shop, talk about what? لا نافع ولا شيء. Nothing benefiting them in dunya ولا آخر. He said nothing benefits except three things. To do ma'roof, anything that is good. Ma'roof is what is known to the world as good. Or sadaqah. We have our brothers and sisters in Syria now. They need food. They need clothes. They need, subhanallah. We have too much. Our freezers are, don't close, filled with all kinds of meat. Moose meat, deer meat, camel meat. Forget lamb and this, that's on the bottom now. Everything is there. Pigeon meat. And we're not full. We still want more. We still complain. And the people are starving and dying. Sadaqah. And people here, poor people. Allah says, no good in their gathering except ma'roof, sadaqah, aw islah bayna an-nas. To reconcile between people. Khzu shaitan. Say, a'udhu billahi min ash-shaitan ar-rajim. Forgive each other. This dunya is not going to continue. This is short dunya. You brothers, you haven't been talking for a year or two or three, haram. Call your brother back home. Say, I love you and forgive me. I made a mistake. Bring that ego down. Allah, Allah. Rasulullah swore by this. وَمَا تَوَادَعَ عَبْدٌ لِلَّهِ إِلَّا رَفَعَهُ. If you push yourself and humble yourself, Allah will raise you on the day of judgment above all the creation. What do you want? So we need to simplify Islam. Go back to the basics of Islam. And this is what Prophet ﷺ did. Then, of course, he told to non-Muslims, you're safe. This ummah, you can be part of it. Charter of Medina secures not only the freedom of living, of worshipping the way they like. No. Rasulullah ﷺ never forced anybody. Anybody, you go now see Catholics, Catholic Church, you see priests, they have an Arabic, they have a pin that says noon. Harf and noon. Have you seen that, some of you? If you see Catholic priests, it's a protest. Noon, because ISIS, they will go to in Iraq and Syria, and any family that is Christian and Muslim, they will put harf and noon. Okay, it means Nasrani or something. So now in solidarity, because the Jews in Israel, in Germany, they were by Hitler told to put patches on their, you know, arms, say with the David Star, to distinguish them. That is discrimination. Rasulullah never did that. They dressed up like the Arabs. They lived freedom to pray the way they like. He never even interfered in their religion. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ لَا إِكْرَاهَ فِي الدِّينَ. Islam would be the biggest lie if we were to tell people, no, you accept Islam or you die. Never. There is not. As a matter of fact, I told you, Africa, Indonesia, India. Look what Mu'inuddin Chisti did in India. Read the history, those of you from India or Pakistan. Millions entered in Islam. He didn't have an army. How did Mu'inuddin Chisti succeed? I went to India and I saw, and I ask and I read. I like to read history. I want to know, why was he successful? What were the things? It was not knowledge or lectures or come or this or big YouTube videos. No. It was love. India is the second largest Muslim population in the world after Indonesia. How? We need to study our history and see why we're not successful. Why we're not moving forward. In addition to the fact that we lost barakah, there are other reasons. And also with our own children, we're struggling to keep them in Islam. We don't understand why they behave, why they don't want to do salat. For me, salat is like eating and drinking. Why our children don't look at it the same way? What is wrong with us? What is wrong with the way we present Islam? Go back to the basics. And those people who are knowledge is good. But knowledge is like medicine. The more you eat, the more you get exposed to diseases. Other diseases and side effects. If you don't have a hakim to guide you, that's why they call tabib,
doctor, medical doctor, hakim. He's wise. Hakim means wise. They call him the wise man. We call in Arabic or Urdu, hakim. And that's why they say in Urdu, nim hakim khatar jaan, nim mulla khatar iman. You know, in Urdu they say that half a doctor is dangerous for your life, and half knowledgeable person who doesn't know how to practice deen, all he's a parrot, and he doesn't know how to practice, he is dangerous for your deen. This is wisdom. This is wisdom in Urdu, and you have it in other languages. So very important, inshallah, that we go back to the basics. دخل الرجل عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله أرأيت إن صليت المكتوبات وصمت رمضان وأحللت الحلال وحرمت الحرم أدخل الجنة؟ قال نعم. A man came to the Prophet ﷺ said, يا رسول الله, listen, I'm a simple man. If I do the namaz, the five salats, and I will fast Ramadan, and I will stick to halal, and I will avoid haram, will I enter Jannah? He said, for sure you will. You know, let us go back to the basics. But before that, let us see what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do. Read that charter of Medina. Third thing before he built the masjid, he cleaned up Medina. Aisha radiallahu anha said, Medina was a dirty, polluted city. Look now, subhanallah, Medina is one of the cleanest places. Even when Saudis had the campaign against smoking, the first city that responded and had the most successful was Medina. Even Mecca, you see more smokers than in Medina, subhanallah. Medina, Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cleaned it, and he was cleaning, contributing to cleanliness of the streets. Even the garbage system, he established that. Now, we know Rasul is a Rasul, but we have to study as a leader. Well, that's why Michael Hart said he is the most influential man among 100 people in history. Why? Because not only he was successful in the spiritual realm, but also in the secular world, in the real life. And that's how the message of deen can make a difference, if it's not confined in books, but rather in reality. May Allah give us love of one another. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promised, Al-mutahabuna fi Allah ala minabira min nur yawm al-qiyamah yaghbituhum ash-shuhada'u wal-anbiya. Those who love one another and spread love among Muslims, like the Sahaba did, they will be on high pulpits in the Day of Judgment. The Prophets and the Shuhada will envy them for that. اللهم ارزقنا المحبة فيك وارزقنا محبة المسلمين. اللهم نعوذ بك من البغض والغل. ربنا اغفر لنا وإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. استغفر الله وغفر رحيم. الحمد لله نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الرسول. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل افضل صلواتك على سعد مخلوقاتك سيدنا محمد عدد معلوماتك ومداد كلماتك كلما ذكرك الذاكرون وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون. يا حنان يا منان يا بديع السماوات يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم يا ربنا يا إلهنا يا خالقنا اغفر ذنوبنا وذنوب آبائنا وأمهاتنا ومشايخنا وعلمائنا ومن له فضل علينا. اللهم انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في الشام والعراق وفلسطين. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في سنترال أفريكا. كن مع المسلمين في بورما. اللهم يسر أمر المسلمين في بورما وباكستان والهند وكشمير. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في الصين. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في كل مكان وفي كل زمان برحمتك يا حنان يا منان. اللهم وفقنا للخير وأعنا عليه. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم ارزقنا المحبة فيك وارزقنا محبتك ومحبة رسولك ومحبة من يحبكما. اللهم رسخ في قلوبنا المحبة فيك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم اشفنا من كل داء. نعوذ بك من شماتة الأعداء ومن خيبة الرجاء ومن عضال الداء ومن السلب بعد العطاء. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلي اللهم وسلم على نبينا محمد.